بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome back to my channel QHE تجويد Rules of the Quran channel in English. Our chapter for today, إن شاء الله, it will be about همزة الوصل and همزة القطع. What's the difference between both of them? And how can I know both of them from each other? And how can I get if I just have ألف without any همزة وصل or قطع in top of it, how can I know if it's همزة قطع or وصل? The basic preparation for this chapter of the professional Sheikha Hanan Isam, translated and explained by me. The همزات on the Quran, الهمزات. همزات is the plural of word همزة. شاهد الجزرية for the part of همزات in the Quran وابدأ بهمز الوصل من فعل بضم إن كان ثالث من الفعل يضم واكسره حال الكسر والفتح وفي لأسماء غير اللام كسرها وفي ابن مع ابنة امرئ واثنين وامرأة واسم مع اثنتين. We will explain every single thing on these lines and how can we find the part we need exactly by inshallah explaining the chapter. Let's see an example here for one of the verbs in the Arabic. Verb ذهبَ. ذهبَ is a past tense. The root letters of word ذهبَ, it's ذا الفتحة, ها فتحة, با فتحة. This is how the main letters in this word. And this is past tense. If I ask you to give me the order or command verb from it, how can you give me this verb? It start with ساكن. In this case, it will be ذهب. So it will start with ذال ساكنة ها فتحة با سكون to make it as an order or command verb. So I can't start with ساكن at all as Arab language. Arab in the back and the Arab total can't start with ساكن. It's not in their language. So how can they start in this case? They put همزة الوصل to make it as a stair to avoid this sukun. So it will be اذهب. If you look here, this is همزت الوصل in the beginning. If I don't have this همزت وصل in this case, I will have ذهب. So I will have ذال ساكنة in the beginning. Arab never start with sukun. It will be very difficult and hard for them to start with sukun. So in our Arabic language, we don't have second letter at the beginning at all, at all. So in this case, we use Hamzat al-Wasl to start the word with. Haraka of Hamzat al-Wasl, it can be Fatha, it can be Kasra, it can be Dhamma, depends in the word, and this is what we will explain in our chapter two. We will know when we have it with Fatha, when we will have it with Kasra, when we will have it with Dhamma, or if this kind of Hamza, it's wasl or qata from the beginning. This will be our chapter, inshallah. Hamzat al-qata and Hamzat al-wasl and the difference between them and the haraka of Hamzat al-wasl when I start with. So Hamzat al-wasl, it just come in the verbs? No, it can come in nouns, verbs, or even letters. We will see this inshallah by explaining this chapter. Let's go together and see the notes here. Note number one, Arab never start with second. Remember this one, it's very important. Arab never start with second and never stop on haraka. Arab stop on sukun or by raum or ishmam. So I have another option, which is raum or ishmam. They can stop with raum or ishmam too, but they never stop with haraka at all. Never stop with haraka at all. So they can stop with sukoon or they can stop on raum or ishmam. Raum and ishmam, it's another chapter we'll go through inshallah in the future. But right now, remember, Arab never start with sakin, never stop on haraka. Okay? Let's go here and see. Then, if I have a word that starts with sukoon, how can I read it? How can I pronounce it? I have to have hamzat wasl in the beginning of it to read this word. Because hamzat al-wasl, if I start, it has one of the fatha or dhamma or kasra depending in the word. That means I start with haraka, not with sukoon anymore. This is how it looks in the Quran. Let's go together and see what's hamzat al-wasl. We'll see what's hamzat al-wasl now and how many kind of hamza do we have in the Quran. How many kind of hamza do we have in the Quran? What's hamzat al-wasl? We will explain it inshallah during our explanation. And like I told you right now, hamzat al-wasl, it's a hamza. We pronounce it in the beginning of the word to use it to reach for the second letter of the beginning of the word. So how many kind of hamza do we have in the Quran? We have two kinds. First one is Hamzat al-Qat'a, and you will find it look very clear Hamza. And we have Hamzat al-Wasl, and this is how it looks on the Quran. Little Sad in top of the Alif. It's very simple and easy to open the Quran and find the two shapes of this Hamza, and you can tell this is Hamzat al-Wasl and this is Hamzat al-Qat'a. If you want to go by this way, don't watch our chapter. If you want to know the details about each one of these hamza and how can I know which one is which one, even if I don't have any of them on the top of the alif, or if you want to know when I'm start with fatha or dhamma or kasra for hamzat al-wasl, please watch the chapter till the end. Chapter will be parts. By each class, it will be in one video inshallah. Let's go together and compare between the Hamzat al-Wasl and Hamzat al-Qat'a total to go through the chapter inshallah more. Definition of each one of them. Hamzat al-Wasl, it is the extra Hamza in the beginning of the word. That means it's extra, it's not a part of the word. If I start with the word, I pronounce it, but if I connect, I don't pronounce it. Idhhab, idhhab, this is how I start. But if I connect and I say, for example, antadhhab, antadh, tadh, tadhhab. So I go from the ta fatha to dhal sukun right away. Let's see an example for Hamzat al-Wasl from the Quran. الله الذي خلق سبع سماوات ومن الأرض مثلهن يتنزل الأمر بينهن. If I look here in word الأرض, what happened in this word? I have همزة وصل in the beginning. So if I connect it will be من الأرض. So نون فتحة لام سكون right away. نل. So I drop this Hamza when I connect this Hamzat wasl. But if I start, I can't start with Lam Sukoon because it's the first letter. So what happened? I will put Hamzat wasl here to reach for this Sukoon or to read this second letter. So I can, like I said in the beginning of the class, Arab never start with second. It's very hard for them. I can't start with lam sukun in my regular talking or in my Arabic at all. So that's why Hamzat al-Wasl come here to make me can read this word. So it will be al-ard. همزة فتحة. How can I know the حركة of it? It's inshallah what we will explain during our chapter. But right now, to start with it, I start with همزة فتحة. But if I connect, I drop it. نل. Same here. يتنزل لل لل. لام ضمة ولام سكون right away. But if I start with this word, I will say الأمر. الأمر. So I start with همزة فتحة. So what can we see here? It is the extra همزة in the beginning of the word. If I start with the word, I pronounce it. But if I connect, I don't, or I drop it, or I skip it. Inshallah, clear for you till now. Okay? Hamzat al-Qat'a here, it is the Hamza that is on the word, in the connection, or in the beginning, and it is a part of the word, its main letter on it. So it's a part of the word. It can come in the beginning of the word, middle or end. But Hamzat al-Wasl, it just come in the beginning. Rules of the Hamzat al-Wasl and Hamzat al-Qat'a. Rules of Hamzat al-Wasl, pronounced only when I start, but if I connect it, it is not pronounced. Rules of Hamzat al-Qat'a, pronounced all the time, except on one word in Hafs way. And why I said here Hafs way? Because each qari, each one who give us riwayah, Hafs, Warsh, Hamza, Ya'qub, Abu Amr, any qari, any qari has his own part of Hamzat, has his own way to read the Hamza. That's why I say in Hafs way, the one we study here. So we pronounce all the time the Hamzat al-Qat'a in Hafs way, except in one word, he have tasheel. He read the first one, but the second one, he read it between Hamza and Alif. And we call it tasheel al-Hamza. So how he read this word? A'jami. Not a. A'jami. And there is a special video you can watch on this channel about word A'jami. You can see this video with the details. So, what about al-dhakarayn? What about Allah? This is another story, but this is the word it only has tasheel, or it has hamza. It's not complete pronounced on the Hafs way. Why we call it Hamzat al-Wasl? Because we're able to avoid starting with the second letter. Without it, I can't read the word if I start with the first letter of the word, because it's a second. Remember, in word idhhab, if I take the Hamzat al-Wasl away, I will have the sakina as a first letter in that word. So I can't start with it. Arab never start with the second letter. About Hamzat al-Qat'a, we called it Hamzat Qat'a. Qat'a means I cut. Wasli means I connect. Okay? So Hamzat Qat'a, Qat'a, I cut, because it cuts off what was before from what comes after. For example, word iqra bism. A bism. So I cut on it. I cut on this hamza to go for the next letter. Compare between still hamzat al-wasla and hamzat al-qata. Hamzat al-wasl, not read when connecting, but read when we starting. Hamzat al-qata, read in both cases. Hamzat al-wasl never comes with present tense or four-letter verbs. Never. comes with present tense or verb. It has four letters. Hamzat al-Qata comes in present tense and comes in a verb with four letters. Remember, I told you before we go for this chapter, please watch the morphology on the channel and the basic grammar on the channel too, the chapter of basic grammar. Why? Because all this chapter depends on the morphology and grammar in Arabic. It's very important to know at least the basic of the Arabic in morphology and grammar. So when I told you right now, never comes with present tense, that's mean you have to know the present tense. Okay, or four letter verb, that's mean you know, you have to know the kind of verbs and if it's a verb or noun or letter. We will know everything with details in the future. I just give you like a total summary right now about what we will explain. If it comes after a mad letter, the mad letter is not pronounced. Like, fil arb. You look here, word al arb. If you look here, I have hamzat wasl. If I have mad letter before it, what I mean? I follow the meeting of two second letters, the rules of it. That mean I not pronounce the mad letter here. Fil. Feel from fa kasra to lam sukun right away. I don't say feel arb, I say feel arb, right? But here, if it comes after a mad letter, the mad letter is stretched for 2-5 beats, 4 or 5 beats in half sway. As-sama. So I have hamzat qat' here, and I have mad letter before it. In half sway, I stretch it 4 or 5 beats. Here I not pronounce the mad letter. So this is another difference between Hamzat al-Wasl and Hamzat al-Qata. Tamam? And here I'm talking about this Hamza, not the Hamza in the beginning. Hamza on the beginning here, there is nothing before it in this word to explain it. I'm talking about this Hamza here, Hamzat al-Qat. I'm talking about the Hamzat al-Wasl here, al. Okay? Our next comparing, it will be about only comes at the beginning of the word, Hamzat al-Wasl, like I just said, but Hamzat al-Qata' comes at any part of the word. It can be beginning, it can be middle, it can be end. There is no problem at all. It's one of the main letters in Arabic. Hamzat al-Wasl doesn't come in a word as a question. Never, never. It comes as a question in the word. But Hamzat al-Qata, if it is in a question, this Hamza always has a fatha. So that's mean it's come on the question. It can come on the question. And on this case, it's all the time it will have fatha. I will never find it with anything else, not with dhamma, with kasra, nothing, just the fatha. Like a'alid. A'alid. Okay. A'anta. أأنتم, and so on. Hamzat al-Wasl never comes with sukun because the first letter is second, and we use it to avoid this starting with sukun. But Hamzat al-Qat' can come with haraka anywhere. Can be fatha, dhamma, kasra, but it comes with sukun only in the middle or end of the word. That means I never start with Hamzat Qat'i Sakina, or I will have the same problem. I use Hamzat al-Wasl because to avoid it. Hamzat al-Wasl is written in the Quran by this shape. Hamzat al-Qat' is written in the Quran like this, no matter if it is on the chair or not. That means it can be, like we explained before, Hamzat al-Qat' need a chair to sit in. It can be on the waw like this, or can be on the ya like this, or can be on the alif, or it can be even in the line like word as-sama', or like word ma', or it can be on the yeah, like ulaik and so on. Okay, so hamza all the time it's set on a chair. Hamzat al qatta, hamzat al wasl all the time it looks like that. Okay, inshallah clear for you. By this, our lesson for today is completely done. We will still in the beginning of hamzat al wasl and hamzat al qatta. I give you important information today. That's great if you try to write it and keep it with you as a notes. Inshallah, our next classes, we will explain more and more about Hamzat al-Wasl and Hamzat al-Qata with a lot of details. Again, if you feel this chapter is hard for you, don't go through it. And it will be the first video I explain today. It will be important for you if you don't want to go through details. And there is another video, inshallah, I will put it as, when I record it, I will put it for you as an important one. I will put it for you somehow in the description box to make it clear for you. This is important if you want to know the summary or how can you know the easiest way for Hamzat al-Wasl and Hamzat al-Qata without going through all this. But this is, again, for the one who want to be a teacher or a professional to go through this chapter. Thank you so much to watch my channel again, QHE Tajweed Rules of the Quran channel in English. Jazakumullahu khairan. See you inshallah in the next class. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.